May I now invite our ambassador, Mr. Navdeep Suri, to come in and address the audience. Thank you.
Your Highness, Sheikh Nahyan, my dear old friend, Sunil Munjal, ladies and gentlemen, I arrived in Abu Dhabi about 3.5 months back, and I have to say that this has been the most productive, the most busy time of the 33 odd years that I've spent in the Indian diplomatic service. It's unusual for a diplomat that you arrive fresh into a country and you have the unique privilege of organizing and being involved with the visit at a head of state level for His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed. And you know, those couple of days in his company and that of his very, very distinguished delegation was, I think, a true milestone in our relationship. I just want to share two little anecdotes about the visit. It was very overcast on the 26th of January when the parade was on. And we were very fortunate that it didn't rain on the parade. And soon after, it started raining, and it kept raining the rest of the day. And in the afternoon, around 6 o'clock, 5:30, when we were seeing off His Highness at the tarmac in the VIP area of New Delhi Airport, it was pouring. And holding umbrellas and struggling with the wind and on the red carpet, I asked His Highness, I hope you had a good visit. And he said, two of the best days of my life. And just a few weeks later, we had the honor to call on His Highness during the defense exhibition when our Minister of State for Defense was here. And he was recalling his visit. And he said something really profound, that the true import of the visit struck him about 2 weeks later, because and after he came back and he started meeting members of the public, the kind of response that he got from members of the public, that how happy they were at his visit to India, he said, I've not heard something similar when I come back from the US or Europe or Japan or other places. It shows the deep emotional and personal connection between the people of UAE and the people of India. And so between those two ends of the spectrum, the one end where Prime Minister Modi and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed speak to each other regularly, on the phone. Last week, Prime Minister Modi called up to wish happy birthday to His Highness. His Highness called the Prime Minister to congratulate him on the UP elections and other victory. That's one end of the spectrum. The other end of the spectrum is the emotional connect between the people. Between those two, we have our job cut out as diplomats in terms of really adding a lot of substance to the relationship. We see that happening in defense cooperation. We see that happening in security. We are today talking with a level of trust and confidence between our countries and our governments that is quite unprecedented. We are sharing information on some of the most sensitive subjects, again, as a manifestation of that trust and confidence that we have built over the last couple of years. But in the context of this very important 60th anniversary and the context of this conference, I just want to dwell a little bit on the economic side. Yes, we can take pride in the fact that India remains UAE's largest trading partner, a $50 billion bilateral trade, the ambitions of our leaders to double it in the next few years. And yes, we can take sort of comfort in the growing business relationship. But I really feel that, honestly, we can also give ourselves a can-do better grade, because there is so much headroom for growth in this relationship. And I was reading a report this morning about the Dubai Chamber of Commerce. The chairman had taken a very high-level delegation to India for a visit. They came back day before yesterday. And he speaks of 36,000 Indian companies that are members of the Dubai Chamber of Commerce. 36,000, 26% of the total membership. That gives us an idea of what we can accomplish. Anecdotally, and I know there is no hard data on this, but anecdotally, I've seen figures that Indian investment in UAE is in excess of $55 billion. And of course, friends of mine in MR and others say that when you look at Burj Khalifa, all you need to do is look at Dr. Shetty and others to know how many Indians own apartments over there. But it also impels me to see how we can attract greater UAE investment into India. And for us, this has become a prime objective in our working for this year, particularly since the leaders have committed to an investment of $75 billion in Indian infrastructure. No other country on the planet has made a similar commitment that UAE has done. So the challenge is for us to turn this into reality. From our side, I can assure you that we've been working. In the last few months, we've had a visit by Minister Nitin Gadkari to speak about opportunities in the highway sector and his ambitious plans to monetize significant clusters of existing government-built toll highways, which can be privatized, and the auction process is going to start in the next month or so. Minister Suresh Prabhu was here to talk about opportunities in the railway sector. India is investing $142 billion in the railway sector in the next 3 years. Over 100 railway stations are being put up for privatization on a 45-year lease. And many of these are valuable investment opportunities. Minister Piyush Goyal was here to talk about renewable energy. We're looking at co-production facilities in defense, and so on. And I have to share with you, Mohan, with your permission, that one of the important outcomes of your visit here is our conversation a little while back, and we've said that we are going to make this effort, that within 2 months, we will try and organize a Startup India Summit here with Mohan and his colleagues. And for me, again, the idea would be to create yet another platform where potential investors from UAE can look at the startup sector in India and see how rapidly it has transformed. I was, until this morning, quoting NASSCOM figures that India is the third largest startup destination in the world, but Mohan has corrected me that we have perhaps become the second largest after the US now. So I am very keen to use this opportunity of being in your midst today in AIMA, and also in the next few weeks, the opportunities that we have through the Conference of the Indian Chartered Accountants Association, the Indian Institute of Directors, the Indian Merchants Chamber, and others, to really carry back one, just one message. There's never been a better time in our relationship. This is the moment. I think together we have to seize it. Thank you very much.